哈利路亚，奉主耶稣圣名正道。
In Jesus' name I speak。
主所亲爱的，大家平安。
My beloved brothers and sisters, peace be unto you。
靠着圣灵的帮助。
By the help of the Holy Spirit。
我们继续在风雨中前进。
We continue to forge forward in the storm。
教会在风雨中不断的前进。
And the church is forging forward in the storm。
福音，神的福音在风暴中不断的前进。
And the gospel of God continue to forge in the storm.
今天十四章我们看到有一个主题叫做花千与石头。
And today there is a topic by, we call it the garland and the stone.
我们看到使徒在花千跟石头中继续的前进。
And we can see the apostle is charging forward between the garland and the stone.
十三章开始是记录保罗开始传道的记录，一直到最后一章。
And starting from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 13 is recording about the beginning of the missionary work of Paul.
那么十三章跟十四章这两章呢，是记录保罗跟巴拿巴旅行布道、世界布道的第一次布道的行程。
And from verses 13, chapter 13 to chapter 14 of the Acts of the Apostles, recording about the evangelical work regarding Paul and Barnabas.
那如果你要了解他第一次世界布道的一些发生的事情跟经过，你就要仔细看十三章跟十四章。
If you want to go into details to know more about this evangelical work of both of them, you have to go through the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 13 and 14.
他们都是从祷告中差派出去，从祷告中出去的。
And they were sent by the prayer.
然后呢，十三章大部分的记录呢，都是在前面。福音前面的一些记录，福音前面的一些记录。
And based on the recording of the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 13, they are all recorded in the first portion of the chapter.
那十四章呢，所记录的大部分已经进入到尾声，后面后半部的福音记录。
And on the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 14, they are recording almost towards the end of their evangelical work.
那么我们从十三章一直看哦，看到今天的十四章。他们就是不断的受到阻挡，受到逼迫了。
So from verses, I mean from chapter 13 to chapter 14, they both face a lot of persecution and stumbling block.
他们本来到那个加拉太省的安提阿那边传福音。
They went to in the beginning they went to this Antioch of the Galatia to preach the gospel.
结果受到犹太人的那种挑唆，叫那些尊贵的妇女还有名望有地位的人来赶他们走。
And they were facing a situation where all these renowned and rich women that came to try to cast them out.
然后他们两个人就跑到五十一节十三章五十一节，他们两个就跑到以哥念去传福音了。
So and in the verse fifty, it was recording about them. They fled to a place called Iconium to preach the gospel.
虽然有逼迫有阻挡，他们对福音的工作没有停止的。
Although they face persecution and hindrances, but they have not stopped preaching.
所以我说他们是福音是在风雨中，在风暴中不断的前进的。
So that's why I say that the gospel was forging forward in the storm.
那么一直到以哥念的时候呢，又受到逼迫了。
And when they arrive at Iconium, they face persecution.
那十四章的第五节。
And chapter 14 was 5.
撒旦动用了三方面的人来攻击他们。
And Satan make use of the three parties of people to attack them.
第一种人叫做外邦人。
First was the Gentiles.
跟主耶稣没关系的，跟教会没关系的人。
They have no relationship with Lord Jesus and the church.
也跟犹太人、跟犹太教没有关系的人。
And they also have no relationship with the Judaism.
这是我们称为世上的人来攻击他们。
And we say that they have been attacked by the people of the world.
第二个呢，魔鬼借助犹太人来攻击他们。
And God, I mean, the devil used the Jews to attack them.
犹太人就是自己家里的人哦。
And the Jews are their own family members.
所以常常逼迫哦，都是来自家里的人。
And they often face persecution within the families.
但是现在又加上外邦人。
And now on top of that, they have this the Gentiles.
这样还不够哦。
And still not enough.
还加上另外一班人，就是官长哦，那些做官的、有势力、有权力的人哦，来逼迫他们。
So above all this, they even have the rulers to come and persecute them.
那这次的逼迫呢？这里说这三方面的人呢，外邦人、犹太人、官长呢，一起涌上来的，就是他们很同心的，同一个动作，同一个时间。同心的涌上来逼迫了。
And the persecution was done by these three parties. They come concurrently.
有没有看到十四章的第五节？
on the chapter 14 verse 5.
然后呢，使徒两位使徒呢。 这里说就逃到路斯德跟特比去了。And
they beware of that, and they fled to Lystra and Derbe.
那传道有解释什么叫做逃，什么叫做逃到那边去。So
I have explained about what's the meaning of flee.
因为我们的观念，中国人的观念，逃这个字就好像你怕死啦，怕辛苦啦，怕这个怕那个，赶快逃啊，保命啊。So
in a common understanding about flee is because you are afraid of some persecution and you're trying to run away.
事实上不是这样的。
In actual fact, it was not so.
传道工人怕死、怕辛苦、怕痛、怕被打、怕逼迫、怕羞辱，你就不用当传道了，你当不了的了。So
if you want to become an evangelist and you are afraid of all this persecution and you can never be successful.
更何况是保罗、巴拿巴，他们那里有怕这种东西的呢？
And even to Paul and Barnabas, they have got no fear about that.
那我为了解释这个逃字，我尽量去看原文的意思。So
I try to look for the original text about the word flee.
原文这个逃字，它是有退让，不跟你相争，我不再跟你吵了，我不跟你争了，你想怎样你就怎样吧，我不理你了。So
the original text, it means that they will not take heed of what you're trying to go against them, and they just want to let it go.
这样你就明白，圣经讲的那个逃跟我们所认为的逃是不一样的。So
the context from the Bible, the flee is different from what we understand.
不跟你争，在圣经常常这样，神常常用这个原则。
In the Bible context, they have these principles that they do not want to fight with you over something.
在创世纪第六章说，神的儿女看人的女子美貌，就随意起来为妻。
So in the Genesis, it's mentioned about the people take daughters of the men as wife.
那么神的灵就不跟他们争。And
the Spirit of God, the Spirit of God did not really
不跟他们辩论呢。Do
not debate over them.
我也不会再讲你的啦。And
the God will not bother.
我也不会再骂你的啦。And
the God will not rebuke.
你想要怎样做你就怎样做啦。Do
what you want.
这叫做神的灵不跟他们争啊，争辩啊。
So the Spirit of God do not want to care about them.
所以这个逃字是他真正意思这样，不再跟你争了。你想要怎样你就怎样，你要拒绝福音你就拒绝，你自己保重，你自己负责任。So
this flee, it means that if you do anything that you want, that it just wouldn't bother.
福音传到最后，如果是这样啊，就没有办法了。
If the gospel was preached to such an extent, and it will.
所以我们不需要跟人家去吵架的，你知道吗？So
we need not have to fight with people.
如果人家很坚决的拒绝，一次又一次的拒绝，甚至羞辱你，甚至逼迫你，那就算了。So
if people trying to
不跟你争了，我不跟你争了。
Continue to mock at you and even to persecute you, and you just leave them alone.
那么他们就跑到哪里呢
？So where did they flee to?
请看十四章的第八节。So
we refer to the chapter 14 verse 8.
他们就走到路斯德城。
So they fled to Lystra.
这里路苏德的福音工作是怎样的呢？
So how is the evangelical work there?
请看8节到10节。
From verses 8 to 10, verse 8, and in Lystra, a certain man without strength in his feet was sitting, a cripple from his mother's womb, who had never walked, verse 9. This man heard Paul speaking. Paul observing him intently and seeing that he had faith to be healed, verse 10. And with a loud voice, stand up straight on your feet, and he leapt and walked.
这里的福音工作就看到，保罗行了一个神迹，医治的神迹。So
this evangelical will include a big miracles that Paul has performed.
就是医好一个生来瘸腿的人，从来不能够走路的人起来行走。So
a man who was born lame and he was healed.
那么这个人第十节说，就站起来，跳起来，而且行走。And
verse 10 mentioned that he stand up straight. On the feet, and he leapt and walked.
这里的情形跟描述跟《使徒行传》3章彼得行的那个神迹一模一样。So
he mentioned about the earlier miracle performed by Peter was the same.
你看，使徒保罗所行的神迹跟彼得所行的神迹几乎拿来对比都几乎是一样的。So
the miracles performed by Paul and Peter, they are indeed the same.
这个神迹呢，在当时，在当 当代的那个地方轰动起来。So
it made an uproar at that point of time, at that place.
今天许多信徒也是瘸腿，有脚但是不能够走路。
And today there are many believers who have leg but are actually lame.
我们除了我们的脚不能够走路，其他样样都可以，样样都OK的。
Apart from we are being lame, but we can do any other things than that.
我们的眼睛是可以看圣经的。
Our eye can read the Bible.
我们的耳朵是可以听道理的。
Our ear can hear the sermon.
也是可以做很多事情的。
Our hand can do many works.
我们的头脑，我们的心都可以想很多东西，可以思想的。
Our head and our heart, we can ponder and think about many things.
几乎样样都没问题。
Almost everything that there's no challenge.
就是走不到神的面前。
It's only one problem is we can't walk towards God.
就是走不到教会里面来。
We can't walk towards the church.
这就是瘸腿。
That is why we are lame.
很多信徒的病都这样子。
So this is the common sickness of many believers.
所以一定真的是要圣灵来医治我们，让我们的这个属灵的瘸腿病好起来，能够走路走到神的面前来。
Truly, we need the healing from Holy Spirit that we will be healed from the lame and walk towards God.
我们要祷告求神医治我们。We
have to pray and ask God to heal us.
在启示录说，大家都要到最后就要自己走到神的面前了，要自己走啊。
So at a revelation recorded that we have to walk by ourselves towards God.
没有背你的，没有说抱着你这样来走的，没有的。
No one will put you at the back and walk for you.
那个约翰长老他在启示录看到异象嘛。 看到一群穿白衣的人嘛。
Elder John saw a vision about one group of people who are in white gown.
那么他就问天使，这些人是从哪里来的，从哪里出来的，这些穿白衣的人。
So he asked the angels, who are these people, where they come from?
那天使告诉他，这些人都是从大患难中自己走出来的。
And the angels replied and said that they came out of great persecution.
而且这些人都是经历患难，经历痛苦，经历逼迫。 经历信仰的考验的人来的。
And these are the people who have gone through persecution and the test of faith.
这种经历大患难，圣经是写大患难，不是小患难。那肯定他们身上就受伤的，他们的身上肯定受很多伤的。
So these people have gone through a very great tribulation that they are indeed badly hurt.
没有受伤就不叫做大患难哦。
If they are not hurt, they will not be in the great tribulation.
可是在此后，主耶稣有没有抱着他们走啊？有没有啊？有没有背他们起来走啊？没有。 甚至说他们自己走出来的，自己走到神面前去。
At last, they were not taken out by Lord Jesus, but they rather walk by their own feet towards God.
如果我们今天信仰上有瘸腿的这个信仰病，不能走路，你一定要祷告，祷告主耶稣要医治你，圣灵要医治你。
Today, if we are lame in ourselves, that we have to pray and ask God to heal us.
一定要自己走到神的面前来。
We have to walk to God by our own feet.
你注意看，传道在聚会时常常呼吁要到教会，不断的常常都在呼吁。
So I continue to reiterate that we have to walk towards the church.
以前不能够到教会，那前面几个不能到教会，又说不能到教会。现在可以到教会了，又没有来教会。
So the past few months that we cannot come to church because there were a reason, but now if we can go to church and we still don't come.
这个是医治瘸腿的一个重要的启示跟对我们的一种勉励。
And this is a revelation of to heal our lame and a form of exhortation to us.
发生什么事呢?
And what happened?
11节,
verse 11. Verse 11. Now when the people saw what Paul had done, they raised their voices, saying in the Lyconian language, the gods have come down to us in the likeness of men.
当这个地方的人看到保罗行这个神迹的时候，大声说，有神借着人的形象降临在我们当中呀。
So he's saying that there is a God who came down from us in the likeness of man.
简单说，神显现在我们这个城市，显现在我们这里。
And in simple language, that it is God who appeared himself in this city.
这个是来自撒旦的大试探。
And this is a great test from the Satan.
如果这件事保罗他们不谨慎不谦卑，就会抢夺了神的荣耀了。
If Paul were not vigilant, then he will take the glory from God.
而且更可怕的是，这里的人有人把你当作神来拜，把你当作神来赞美、来称赞。So
the worst is that the people will praise them like God.
把人当作神是亵渎神的事情，知道吗？
So they treat men like God is indeed a blasphemy.
因为神是圣洁的。
Because God is holy.
你把人这么污秽的人，这么有罪的人，把他当作你就是神，那么你把神当作什么？ 你跟神跟人同等啊，比在一起啊。
So how can they treat a filthy man with the rank of God who is so noble?
所以把人当作神，那是很大的亵渎神的事情。
So if you treat man as God, that means it is a great blasphemy.
对我们来讲，对使徒们讲是个大试探来的。
So to the apostles is a great test to them.
那么他们就把这个保罗跟巴拿巴称为其中神的名字。
So they gave name to Paul and Barnabas concerning their gods that they worship.
12节
Verse 12. And Barnabas they called Zeus and Paul Hermes because he was the chief speaker.
13节
Verse 13. Then the priest of Zeus, whose temple was in front of their city, brought oxen and garlands to the gates, intending to sacrifice with the multitudes.
好，那原来哦，在他们的故事当中啊，他们的传说当中啊。这个地方离高尼人啊，他们迷信哦，从前曾经有天神啊，丢失啊，和西米尔哈、哦、化作人的形象来到凡间，来到他们的城市。
So they have this myth of belief that their god and was called Zeus and Hermes who came to their city.
但是路斯德的众民啊，那时不认识他们是神哦，不理睬他们，不接待他们。
And at that time, the god that they Lucifer
这个城啊，这个城叫
the people of Lystra they do not recognize the god that came to them.
那唯有一对年老的夫妇哦，接待这两位天神呐、啊。
Only the two elderly couples who receive these two gods.
后来那个天神就奖赏这一对老夫妻。
And later these two gods and has a award rewarded this.
把其他的众人，这个城市的人都惩罚了，毁灭了。
And God destroyed the entire city as a form of punishment.
这是他们迷信传说的神话故事。神曾经来过他们这里，他们不认识，他们没有接待，结果受到惩罚。
So that was the myth that they believed that these two gods came to their city and they did not receive them.
传道为什么要跟你们讲这个迷信传说的故事呢
？So why I share with you this myth?
因为传道要向你要解释为什么要把巴拿巴叫做丢失。要把保罗称为称为什么？称为西俄米？为什么
？And this why they call Barnabas Zeus and Paul Hermes？
因为这个就是他们刚才所说的迷信传说的那两位神来的呀。
And that was indeed the two gods in the myth。
现在呢，这两位天神又从天上下来了，重新再来到我们的城市了。
So they deem that these two are their gods, which they have forgotten, and now in their city.
化作人形，一个神化作保罗，一个神化作巴拿巴，他们就是神来的呀。
So one Barnabas becomes Zeus, and also Paul becomes Hermes. Is actually their two gods.
这对于我们对神的仆人是不是很大的试探呢？
So is it a great test to these two disciples of God?
这是不是对真神天上的独一真神很大的羞辱亵渎呢
？Doesn't it a form of a shame that had brought towards the God in heaven?
那么巴拿巴称为丢失，就是众神之王，众神之王。
And Barnabas that they call Zeus is indeed the God of all gods.
神中神啊，神中里面的神啊。
It is God of all gods.
保罗还输给他哦。
Even Paul is more inferior than them.
那为什么保罗会称为西俄米呢
？And why Paul was named Hermes?
因为这个西俄米原来是他们的传信的神，传消息的使者。
Hermes is a messenger.God of messenger
因为这个传信息的使者很会讲话，很有口才。
And because the God of messenger was eloquent,
所以这里有解释嘛，称保罗为西俄米，因为他说话灵手，很厉害讲话。
And they call Paul Hermes because he's good in his speech.
如果我们也糊涂的话
，if we are also
不警醒的话
，if we are not vigilant,
魔鬼在他们两个人当中哦，挑破离间啊，放毒呀，放嫉妒。让嫉妒让他们去腐化他们
And the devil can always create a confusion among two of them, and both of them will be corrupted.
两个都是神，我也是神，你也是神。
Both are also God.
已经够荣耀，够过瘾了。
They already felt glory.
可是我不甘心哦，我小过你哦，你是众神之神哦，你凭什么呀？
But it could be one feel not balanced in the heart because I'm more inferior than you.
输过我，做工又输过我，什么都输过我，我不服你啊
！And all the things that I do, and I'm better than you. And how come now I'm more inferior in such a way?
如果使徒们自己骄傲、自己糊涂、自己不谦卑，真的会心里面会有起了嫉妒的。我跟你讲。
So if the disciples are not vigilant and they're being high-minded, and they will have
hatred among themselves.
这个不是说传道想多了，这真的会发生的呀。
This is not because I give more thought over it. It's actually it's going to happen.
你没有听过这个 扫罗王跟大卫王的故事吗？
Have you heard of the King David and Saul?
扫罗为什么这么恨大卫？为什么要让大卫死掉？为什么？
Why Saul hated David so much?
也就是人家讲一句话而已啊。
It's just because of a sentence.
那些妇女说，扫罗杀死千千，大卫杀死万万，顶不顺了。这句话听了顶不顺哦。
So he says, Saul kills thousands and David kills tens of thousands.
你厉害过我啦。
That means you're better than me.
你在我之上啦。
So you're more superior than me.
从那一天开始，甚至说从那一天开始就恨。 就极恨这个大卫了。
So at that immediate moment that Saul hated David.
如果你谦卑的，
if you are humble,
你敬畏神的，
and you fear God,
当然没问题。
Of course, there's no issue.
但如果你是骄傲的，
but if you are proud,
你自己很想成为神的，
and you also want to be God.
现在人家都当你是神了，
and people treat you like God.
不是你想当，人家已经认为你是神了。
Not because you want to be God, but people treat you as God.
但是有人比你更是神啊，比你更厉害啊。
But you discover that someone is even more superior than you.
你受得了吗？
Can you take it?
这我看呢，这是在另一个灵界的征战，另一个灵界的试探。
So I treat it as another form of a spiritual battle.
魔鬼很厉害的呀。
The devil is indeed very powerful.
他有更深的试探在里面。 从这个试探里面，还看到另一个更深的试探在里面。
So this is the first trial, but then in the devil, he even have another more severe trial.
跟着十三节后，他们就牵牛啊，祭司牵着牛啊，来包括花圈呐，来献给他这两位使徒啊。
So the priest brought oxen and garlands to the gates, intending to sacrifice. To disciples,
送花圈好给他们带呀，
and to offer the garlands for these people to worship.
这肯定是来自撒旦的试探。
Indeed, this was the test of the Satan.
直接说，撒旦给你带花圈，就是荣耀你。
And meaning to say that Satan is trying to bring glory to you.
人没有荣耀你，教会没有荣耀你，同工没有荣耀你，我来给你荣耀，我来制造荣耀给你。
If the believers and the members of the church did not glorify you, but I as Satan, I will glorify you.
撒旦常常做这种试探的工作，给你荣耀，给你戴花圈，给你爽，给你高兴，给你骄傲。
So Satan often would like to create such an act to glorify you.
这些荣耀都是从人来的，从人来的荣耀来的。
And all this glory came from men.
如果传道工人一时不小心哦，都会犯这个毛病的。
And if you are not careful, and you will fall into this snare,
特别我们会有意无意的，甚至故意的制造荣耀在我们的身上。
So whether intentionally or unintentionally, this will happen to us.
让大家来称赞我们，让大家来支持我们，让大家来不断的跟随我们。
So let the people come and praise me and to follow me.
这些荣耀都是从人来的荣耀。
And all these glories came from men.
我们看约翰福音书第五章。
Let's refer to the Gospel of John, chapter 5.
第五章，我们读41节。
We refer to verse 41.
41节。
Verse 41.
我不受从人来的荣耀。
I do not receive honor from men.
主耶稣直接说，我不受从人来的荣耀，这些都是从世界来的，从人来的。
Lord himself said that I do not receive honor from men.
如果我要荣耀，我要从神那边来的，神给我的。
If I want glory, I can get from God.
看44节。
Let's refer to verse 44.
你们互相受荣耀，但是却不求从独一之神来的荣耀。耶稣责备他们。
So Jesus rebuked them who receive honor from one another and do not seek the honor that comes from the only God.
你们自己称赞来称赞去，捧来捧去，大家称赞来称赞去，都有目的，都有利益的。但是你们不从神那边来的荣耀，只看重人的荣耀。
So when you honor one another, but if you did not seek the honor from God, then what's the point?
所以今天人家给你戴花圈哦，这个是从人来的荣耀，这是从撒旦来的试探。
So if someone were to put a garland over your neck, and then this is a test from the Satan.
我们教会有传道人，因为在我们在耶稣教会当传道很辛苦了。
As a preacher in working as a preacher in the church is indeed very tough.
我所谓的辛苦哦，是比起外教会，我们是确实是辛苦的啦。
So what I mean is, comparing with the secular churches, we are indeed tougher.
因为我们的工钱又很少，我们的生活又很少，真的很少。
Because our income are very little from the church.
有个外教会的信徒听到了我们的生活会，他吓到他说有搞错没有？你们的真耶稣教会，随便我们教会的传道人、牧师，十几千以上的，十千以上的都很多呀。 10,000以上，你听好呢。
So a member from the secular church,
那个是不是很高的要求？那是很别别性的东西啊。
Yes, understood that the preachers work in True Jesus Church. The pay was so low, cannot compare even to the pastors of the secular church who earn more than tens of thousands.
信徒有时私下都会送东西给牧师的呀。
Even to their believers, they may even make some gift and give it to the pastors.
他说刚刚不久上个月后，我们教会一个信徒送牧师一辆新的车给传给牧师。
Just not too long ago, one of our believers gifted a car to our pastor.
那辆车也要100多千呢。
The car will cost more than 100,000. And to them is something very common.
他问我你现在拿多少钱？
They ask me how much do you earn.
我说我们不要讲钱呐，我们侍奉神不要讲钱呐。
So I told them that when we serve, we do not talk about money.
那你不要钱，总是要吃饭呐。
But if you do not want money, you still have to eat.
那我跟他讲，我现在 3,100块。
So I told them that my salary is 3,100.
3,100这么少啊？
Is it so little?
我说我做了三十年呐，三十年才达到3,100块。你听好啊，三十年里面。
So, I have rendered my service for 30 years, then only I can achieve this figure of 3,100. If some of these preachers who are not loyal,
他跑到外教会当传道了,
if they go to the secular churches to become a preacher,
我讲的是真实的事情,
what I'm talking is true.
他一到外教会去, 外教会给他车, 给他十几千的工钱, 要买一辆新车给他, 又买手表送他。
So if you go to the secular churches, they will give him all these perks that buy them new cars and a new watch.
然后呢，因为他讲到有恩赐嘛，然后就安排电视节目给他上节目去布道，那变成有名了，非常红了。
Because he's gifted in his speech that they specially arranged for a TV program for him to broadcast.
他回来我们这些书记会叫我们过去，叫我们的传道人过去那边。
So he returned to True Jesus Church and encouraged our preacher to go to that church.
他讲一句话,
he said one word.
真耶稣教会给不到我们的，外教会全部都可以给我们。
He said,
你要什么他都可以给你。
What True Jesus Church cannot give you, the other church can give anything you want.
今天为什么讲这种事情?
And why today I speak of this?
教会没有给你荣耀是吗?
Didn't church give you any glory?
弟兄姐妹没有给你鼓励是吗?
Brothers and sisters did not give you encouragement.
批评你啊，讨厌你是吗？
They continue to persecute you and also to criticize you.
我们的教会可以给你，你要的东西，任何东西都可以给你，而且高高兴兴的给你。
You come to my church that we can give you happily with what you want.
事实上，我们这些书记在传道讲道理是感谢主有一些恩赐的。
Thanks God that the speakers in the True Jesus Church, they are indeed sometimes very gifted.
并且我们都是有圣经根据，翻来翻去都有圣经根据的。
And we are indeed very biblical.
我们要在外教会讲道理是很简单的，跟你讲，都很受欢迎了，简单讲。
But to speak in these secular churches to us is only a very simple thing.
这个有没有归给神啊？传道在外教会讲过道理，那个感受传道知道，他们真的一直叫我去。
So I have this experience to speak in the secular church, and all glory to God. I know it is that simple.
有时软弱起来，就觉得在教会讲道理都没有人要理你啊，都没有人要觉得是很宝贵啊，没有。Sometimes
we felt we are so weak that in our own church when we spoke, and then very little people bothered.
有时觉得，如果在外校区去，哇，成功了，又有荣耀了，真的给我带花圈呢，真的很多花圈会带在我们身上呀。
So sometimes when we speak in the secular churches, I indeed can feel the glory and they can even put a garland over my neck.
这个就是带花钱的意思。
This is what you mean by putting a garland on your neck.
给你荣耀，给你快乐，给你爽，给你样样利益啊。
To give you the glory, the pleasure and everything that you want.
保罗从传道到现在，信主到现在，哪有人给他花钱的呀？
Paul, since the day he believed in Christ, did he receive any garland?
就在十四章这一段的时候，就给他带花圈了，撒旦给他带花圈了。But
when he comes to the chapter 14, Satan put a garland on him.
世界说他就是神啊，你们就是神来的呀。Straightforwardly,
and they claim that he is God.
所以我一直强调，这个是魔鬼，来自魔鬼大试探来的。So
I often reiterate that this is a great trial of Satan.
这就是耶稣说，从人来的荣耀。
And this is what Jesus said, that this is glory for men.
就是主耶稣说, 你们互相受荣耀, 你给我给你, 给来给去。
So this is what Jesus meant by they honor one another.
感谢神,
thank God.
我们今天还在真耶稣教会里面当神的仆人。
So we are still the servant in True Jesus Church.
就像保罗这样, 人家给我们带花圈, 我们不理他, 我们把花圈丢掉。
So we liken to Paul that the people who give us this garland and we just rejected them.
那后来呢, 你花圈不要是吗? 给你带花圈你不要是吗?
And later you discovered that you rejected the garland.
我们就看到你不要花圈, 我就给你石头的了。
He said, if you reject the garland, then I will give you the stone.
石头在哪里?
So where's the stone?
请看这个19节。
Verse 19,
前面,
verse 19, the Jews from Antioch and Iconium came there, and having persuaded the multitude, they stoned Paul and dragged him out of the city, supposing him to be dead.
哎呀, 19节我们看到保罗极可怜啊。
Verse 19, we can see that indeed very pitiful, Paul was pitiful.
刚刚13、14节才给他带花钱啊, 才过了几节而已, 就给他丢石头给他了, 有没有?
Just only a few verses away, he was... given the glory, and now he was stoned.
这里不单只是丢石头啊, 用石头打他, 打到他以为他死了, 真的以为打死他了。
So they stoned him, and he was indeed looks like going to die.
然后这里说, 把他拖到城外, 用拖到, 像一个尸体啊, 死了的人家拖到丢了, 拖出去丢的呀。
So he,
他们认为他已经死了的。
So they assumed that he was dead, and then they dragged him like a dead corpse.
不是只是啊, 受伤这样, 不是, 他们打的人哦, 逼迫他们也认为他死了。
So those who stoned him assumed that he was dead.
看20节,
verse 20.
哦, 第一哦, 门徒正在围坐他, 他就起来走了。
So that when the disciples gathered around him, and then he rose up and went into the city.
后来他在其他的书信中 有谈过这件事情啊, 他保罗有回忆这件事情啊, 很痛苦, 很可怕的逼迫, 很大的逼迫。
He indeed recap what happened here in another episode of Paul.
那我要讲的是什么呢?
So what I'm trying to tell.
我们有一句话说, 江湖话, 江湖里面有一句话说,
There's a worldly saying.
敬酒不吃, 吃罚酒。 我敬你, 我尊敬你, 尊敬你, 给你, 哦, 你不要, 你要喝罚酒。
So that's trying to mean that when you are honored in that moment and you reject it.
撒旦说, 我给你荣耀, 给你尊荣, 给你好处, 你不要啊, 不要, 我就拿石头丢你啊。
So the Satan will say that when I give you the glory and you reject it, and now I will stone you.
我们看到撒旦追杀保罗, 是千刀万里追啊, 他跑到哪里都一直追啊, 追着来杀呀。
So Paul was pursued by the Satan for many thousands of miles.
从安提阿, 追杀他, 追到以哥念, 从以哥念又追到这个路斯德来啊。
So from Antioch to Iconium, and from Iconium to Lystra.
那保罗真的受了很大的逼迫了。
Paul indeed was badly persecuted.
那有一个问题就是, 打保罗的时候, 为什么只打保罗呢? 没有, 那个巴拿巴跑去哪里啊? 巴拿巴没有记录呢。
So there is a question that why they only stone Paul, but there's no record about Barnabas.
难道这段时间保罗自己去传福音吗? 还是巴拿巴在教会里面呢? 还是怎么样?
Or when it came to that juncture, only Paul went to evangelize, not Barnabas.
事实上找不到答案啊, 找不到那蛛丝马迹。
So in actual fact, there's no trace about that record.
又或者他们两个都在, 但是撒旦只选择性的选择一个人来打, 一个 不打他,
it could be in the scenario that Satan only select one like Paul, 如果, only persecute him.
如果这样啊, 又是另一种迷惑, 另一种试探哦, 另一种,
if it is the case, and it will seems to be like another test.
如果真的是这样哦, 两个人都在的时候, 保罗被打, 巴拿巴没事哦, 没搞笑哦, 还帮我们说道理, 没说那么大声哦, 说小声点哦, 我们打被人家打死啊, 你看保罗说那么大声啊, 被人家打死啊。
So the test could be that Barnabas will feel, since Paul spoke so strongly for the words of God, and he shouldn't speak so strong because he will be persecuted.
你看就是只有打他都没有打我啊，因为他很凶啊，因为他才能骂人嘛。
Paul was indeed very staunch, and then he was persecuted, not me.
不要讲这么大声，不要得罪信徒，不要得罪人家。 So 好好讲道理就好了。
So not to speak so loud and not to contradict any believers and just speak a normal sermon will do.
如果是这样，是另一种的迷惑，另一种的试探。
So you could end up in another form of deception.
这样让很多传道工人都退缩了，都不敢真正的勇敢的来辩为真理来辩护了，不敢。
So as a result, it will make many the evangelists become frightened.
虽然还在传福音但是那种力度、那种力量、那种勇敢。那种忠心是已经扣分了的，已经褪色了的，
so,
已经真的褪色了。
They are still there evangelizing, but the impact and the result will not be that good.
所以真正的原因理由我们真的不知道，我也不知道。
So we do not know the actual reason behind it.
两个人常常都记录两个人出去传福音的，为什么一个被打，一个没有被打的呢？
So both of them were always been recorded working together, but why now in this persecution only one received and the other none?
那么让我很感动的是，让我们很感动的是什么呢？
And we were very much moved.
你看二十节。
Let's refer to verse 20.
二十节，门徒正围坐他了，门徒也真的以为他死了，都没有救他。你看，就是围坐来看啊，以为也真的以为他死了。
And the disciples gathered around him and assumed that he was dead.
他就起来。走进城，请看第二天第二天就同巴拿巴往特比去了。
So he went up into the city, and the next day he departed with Barnabas to Derbe.
你看到从这里你看到什么
？What can you see from here？
这个就是传道人的勇敢的精神。
So this is the courage, spirit of the courage from the
就是传道人不怕死的精神。
And fear no death. This is the spirit of fearing no death.
这个就是传道人对福音真理主耶稣忠心的精神。
So this is true the filial and belief of not afraid of dying.
起来，进城去。
Rise and walk into the city.
是吗？这里讲啊，他们把他从城里拖出来了，他现在起来了，又回到城里面去。就是回到那些逼迫他的那些人的地方去。
So he was first dragged out from the city, and now he rose up and went back into the city.
哎，你头脑有问题啊
？Do you have any problem with your mind？
你是被打到气心了啊
？Were you been beaten until you become insane？
刚刚他们才打死你，差点把你打死，就是不要再看到你，不要再让你再去。你为什么还跑回去啊？你想死啊？你想死多一次啊？
So when just now they were trying to kill you, meaning that they want you to be dead, and now you want to return, you want to die another time.
所以我说这个是最感动我的地方了。
So this is something that has moved me the most.
哦，不是因为那边逼迫我，那边打我，我就不要再去，我又不敢去。不是，我还是倒回去。
It's not because of the reason that I was persecuted at that place, and now I refuse to return there.
那是在向他们见证主耶稣。
So he's bearing testimony about Lord Jesus.
我们为了让你们得到福音，让你们去认识真神，让你们进天国，我们可以连生命都不要的，我们可以连死都无所谓的。
So for your sake of knowing the gospel and to be saved, and for us, we are not even afraid of dying.
我们这样做是为了什么？
So what is the reason?
又不是贪你的钱，又不是贪你的东西，你们也没有给我们什么东西。
It is not for your money, and you indeed did not give us anything.
你们把我打到这样，打到这么痛苦，差点死掉，几乎死掉，为什么我们还要倒回来？
So
应该有很多人会去思考，会被感动的。
So people will ponder upon why Paul act in such a manner that I'm going to be beaten to death, but I still return.
纵使那边那这个城的人不会感动，不会反省。至少我们传道人看到这里会反省啊，我看到了我就会反省啊，我在检讨我自己啊，最少现在这个功用就发生了，在我身上不断的反省啊。
Even the people of the city they do not think, but then to me as an evangelist that I have to ponder upon why it happened to me like that.
所以说这个就是我们真正传道人的精神来的，真正勇敢的精神，忠心的精神来的。
So this is truly the spirit of courage of the evangelist.
保罗倒回去进入城里面，是向我们传道人做一个非常正确、非常需要的榜样。
So when Paul
做一个很好的榜样
returned to the city, he indeed had shown a very good example.
不要怕死，不要怕痛，不要怕被打，打了痛了还是回去。
So not afraid to be beaten, not afraid to die, and even though he has suffered, and he still returned.
所以有时我常常听传道同工这样讲。
So I often hear my coworkers say,
一头蜡烛两头烧，他自己哪来衰啊？他自己哪来辛苦啊？蜡烛哦，前面又点火，后面又点火，两头都点火，那当然很容易，很快就融掉，很快就死掉嘛。他的意思说，你的生命这样很快就会死掉了。
So this preacher described that the candle was burned in both sides, and then he actually was looking for trouble.
有时候讲起来好像有道理哦。你两头点干什么？你就慢慢点，慢慢烧啊，可以烧到70岁、80岁才死掉啊，那蜡烛才融掉啊。你现在前面两个点一直烧一直烧，50岁就结束了咯。
So indeed, he can.
有些同工常常这样跟我讲了。
So he can just burn one side of the candle, and that will take longer time for him to consume. But then, if you were to burn the both side, and you can end very early.
有时蜡烛点头的不是我们自己要去点的，主耶稣点的呀。主耶稣在燃烧我们呢、啊。
Sometimes the candle is not lighted up by ourselves, but it's from Lord Jesus, because Jesus wants to rekindle us.
不是自己要去两头烧，不是这样，是主耶稣要我们去烧，要用我们，要这样的付出，要这样的照亮这个黑暗的世界。
It is not that we want to light up ourselves, but rather than Lord who do it for the purpose of lighting up the world.
那如果用这个理论来看哦，这种道理来看，那保罗起来了，又倒回城，那不是笨，那个不是傻瓜吗？那不是他很愚蠢的事情吗？
So in such a theory, if Paul were to return to the city, doesn't that he seems to be like a fool?
你这样是在亵渎一个传道人呢。
If you do that, you are blaspheming a evangelist.
你在羞辱一个传道人呢，你这样子。
You're blaspheming a evangelist.
你都没有受过什么苦啊！他几乎为福音被打死的人啊，他还这样倒回去，你以为他神经病啊？
Yeah.
他为什么这样做？
So you have not suffered any things like Paul suffered, but he still returned.
那我讲一个经历吧。
I will share with you an incident.
花圈跟石头。
The garland and the stone.
有一个传道人哦。
There's a preacher.
在那个神学的时候，他就向主耶稣祷告。
So he was praying to God in the theological class.
毕业的时候呢，千万哦，主耶稣啊。千万不要派我去那一个区啦，那整个区。
So he said when he graduated, and Lord, please don't send him to that area.
因为我软弱啊。
Because I'm weak.
因为我没有力量啊。
Because I'm strengthless.
那个区是魔鬼很多的地方啊。
So that place is has a lot of working of the devil.
这句话不是我讲的。
This word is not said by me.
是杨长老已经过世的杨长老讲的。
So he was spoken by the late Elder Yang.
他来到马来西亚的时候
，When he came to Malaysia,
他就到那一个区去。
So he went to that region.
他在台上讲了三次
，He spoke
三次
，He spoke three times.
我们就坐在台下听得很清楚。
We heard very clearly at the bottom.
他说他走过世界很多各区去牧养去寻牧教会，世界各地。
So he has been to many places in the world.
没有一个区，没有一个教会有这么多魔鬼集中在一起的。
So there's none of the place that have so many devils who converge together.
他这样讲当然有他的原因呐、啊，他的感受啦。
Of course, he has his feeling.
他又不是说没有到过世界的，他到处世界去看，什么教会他都看过，什么人他都接触过。
So、
可是他到这里的时候，他说这里是最多魔鬼的地方。
So he has been to many places of the world and met many people in the world, but then this is the place where he said the most.
那么这个传道人呢，这个神学生呢，看前辈们呢，前辈就是前辈老工人啊，老传道啊，一个一个在这个区里面受很大的伤害，甚至辞职，就在这个区里面、哦、受伤了，
so,
甚至有些回家了。
So there are some even the senior preachers they were very persecuted in this area.
所以这个传道在神学的时候跟主耶稣说：“主耶稣啊，我软弱啊，你不要害死我啊，不要出来当传道，没有两三年就结束了啊。”所以说你不要派我去啊，直接讲我就好了啦。哎呀，这么假装。我跟主耶稣讲，你不要派我去啊。主耶稣，我不要去啊，主啊，我没有力量啊。
The preacher was indeed it's me that I pray and ask God not to send me to this area because I know that I'm strengthless and weak。
结果你最怕的是吗？你最怕的是吗？主耶稣就是特别派你去，一去就去十几年，一派去没有离开了，就十几年在那边。
The more that you are afraid and you refuse to go, but you are actually sent. And once I was sent and I was there for more than 10 years.
我讲的都是真实的见证来的。
I'm telling you the truth.
我真的怕哭啊，主耶稣啊，不要派我去啊，就是派你去。
So I was so afraid till I cried, and then but I still be sent there.
我不要死这么快呀、啊，我不要跌倒呀、啊。
So I don't want to fall and die early.
结果在那边十几年里面，我在那边辞职了啊，丢了两封辞职信在那边。
So eventually at that place,
接好了，但是要拿出去的时候啊，主耶稣来提醒啊，来管教了。
So I actually was trying to tender resignation twice, but then I was reminded by Lord Jesus not to do that.
本来不是这样的。
In actual fact, it wasn't like that.
那是受得到很大荣耀的。
In fact, it was.
我得到很大荣耀的。
In fact, I was I received a great glory.
甚至有一个老信徒了，资深的老信徒了。
A very renowned senior member.
是甚至人员的家人来的了哈。
So he was a family members of the minister.
有一次我讲完道理，安息日，他在后面那边叫我来，他在用手一直叫我来，传道来。
So after I finished my sermon on the Sabbath day, and he was at the back raising the hand at me and asked me to come.
我觉得有什么事情呢
？So I asked him what happened.
不然你就走过来跟我讲啊，为什么这么神秘呢
？So I thought you can come forward, and why should I go there? Why so mysterious?
人家是长辈啊，我当然要过去啊。
So he's a senior, of course I have to go.
他一见到我说。传道你要小心哦，你不可以骄傲哦，你一定不可以骄傲哦。
So when he saw me, he told me that you have to be careful and not to be proud.
我说什么事情
？He asked him what happened.
你要先答应我，你不可以骄傲。
So you have to agree with me that you will not be proud.
请问，我不要骄傲可以答应的吗
？Let's ask.
我答应你，我不要骄傲。如果我可以答应啊，我就很骄傲了哦。
So、let's...
我可以答应你，我不骄傲的，那就是那个就是骄傲了，因为我可以答应你看我不骄傲的，那个其实就是骄傲了。
So can I agree with you that I will say I will not be proud?
可是他很认真的，你千万哦，你一定要答应我，你不可以骄傲。
But he was serious and asked me that you shouldn't be proud.、
我说求神怜悯我，替我祷告了，什么事情呢
？So I say,
求神保守我吧。
So have God's mercy on me, and then let me know what.
他说他祷告得到主耶稣的启示。
He said he prayed and he has a revelation from Lord Jesus.
主耶稣告诉我，就是告诉他了，只有你可以在这里做工，其他的传道没有一个人可以在这里做工的。
So the revelation from Lord Jesus is that he told me only me I can work in this church, but no other people. This is Lord Jesus who told me.
所以你不可以骄傲
，and you cannot be proud.
很清楚。
Very clear.
只有你在可以在这里做工罢了，其他传道没有一人可以在这里做。
Only you can serve here, no other preachers.
这个是什么
？What does it mean?
这个是给我戴花圈啊。
This is to put a garland on my neck.
给我很大的荣耀啊。
And give me great glory.
这个是带我到天堂飘到天上去啊。
And I was lifted up to the sky.
只有我一个人可以做，我的同工其他传道人都没有资格在这里做工。
Only I can serve, no other preachers than me can serve here.
而且是主耶稣启示他的。
And it is a revelation from Lord Jesus.
你说这是有多这个是有多么的骄傲呢
？You say how glorious that
这个就是很明显的给我戴花签呐、啊。
It very clearly that I was put on the garland.
给我骄傲过后又警告我你不可以骄傲，那就搞错没有？你不要我骄傲，你就不要跟我讲这种话嘛。
So you make me feel so proud, but then after that you warn me, and you shouldn't have said to me.
明明就是要试探我，明明就让我跌倒，让我骄傲的话来的。
So very clearly that you are trying to put me on trial.
我当然在心里面奉主的名赶撒旦嘛。
So in my heart that I cast out the demon in Jesus' name.
我就是拒绝了这个花圈了。
So in simple language that I have rejected this garland.
不可以戴这个花，千万不可以戴这个花。
I shouldn't accept this garland.
这个是很严重的事情。
It is something very serious.
哪里有说其他的传道啊不能够来这里做工的？只有你，哪有这样的事情呢、啊、
？How can it be that only me can work here, but not other preachers?
你开玩笑啊？难道他们没有圣灵啊？他们没有权柄啊？他们没有真理啊
？Please don't joke.
开玩笑啊
！You're trying to tell me that they do not have Holy Spirit, they do not have truth.
他们跟我们都是仆人，而且都是有圣灵的、有真理的，都是传道人来的，有职分的。
So we are all preachers, and we have this the truth.
为什么只有我可以？
How can only I can?
这个就给你戴花签哦。
So that means to say you are put on the garland.
花签你不要是吗
？If you do not want the garland,
真的不久哦，石头噼里啪啦石头丢过来。
And later all the stones will come forward.
那个花签不只是他哦，撒旦也用很多的弟兄姐妹、很多的负责人跟我讲哦，只有你在这里，真的是这样讲。那段时间很多人都这样跟我讲这句话，很奇怪呢。
So not only that the senior members who told me, and even the members of the church also told me the same thing.
就算派其他来，我们也不接受的啦。
He said, even they send other preacher, we will not accept.
如果真的不小心，若不谦卑、不谨慎，真的会跌倒，已经跌倒了。
So if you are not vigilant, and you will surely fall.
啊，结果你不要花钱嘛，你不要撒旦说你不要，那我就给你石头了。
since you rejected the garland, and now I'm going to give you stone.
打到我半死啊，打到我迟滞呀，跟你讲。
So they stone me until I have to tender my resignation.
神保守我，神怜悯我呀。
And it's God's preservation.
这个是另一个见证的啦。
So there's another testimony.
这是，所以我看到这14章哦。 花千跟石头哦，我感触很深呐。
So when I talk about this chapter 14, that it has indeed touched my heart because this is about the garland and also the stone.
真的，撒旦会给你带花圈的，真的。And
the Satan will indeed put a garland on you.
但是如果你不要呢，他就一定会给你石头的。But
if you reject, then they will give you stone.
那个伤害到现在都还在哦，很深。
And the wound is still here today.
这是有关乎到总会里面去的事情哦。So
that things went up even to the GA.
灵界的问题来的。So
it is a spiritual matters.
石头跟花圈。The
stone and the garland.
大概我们今天就先讲到这里吧。So
today we will end here.
好，那么我们星期二再继续哈，继续再讲下去。So
we will continue on the next Tuesday.
愿主耶稣祝福保守我们。And
may the Lord bless and also preserve us.
来唱诗。
Let's sing hymn.
105首。
Hymn number 105.